66 is quieter right now because I'm running less RPM. We have a new dash in it because in the rewiring of the lights in the alternator, we managed to fry the gauges. So it's like we have a new tractor. We got the new power steering system, the new lights. What more could you want? Hey, there's the planter. I shouldn't watch that too long. I really should be watching the marker. But when we look back, we look at our monitor. We see the fertilizer spinning and that knob back there, way in the back. That's also turning, telling us that we're dropping seed and fertilizer. I just refilled before the last down and back, so we're good for a few more acres. I think we get in the range of like 4 to 5 acres per refill. Since we're putting down closer to 225 pounds of fertilizer, we're only getting like 4-something a fill. Not close to 5. We're in high 2 or 6 gear. Not running too fast. Don't need the RPM. That's the nice thing about, you know, the plate planter. We don't need to be sitting there spinning RPMs to run a pump to blow air or suck air or whatever. We can just plant leisurely along. The only annoying thing about the 66, it's got these 30-inch tires. I'm on the lookout for 38s for it. Because when you go down the road, it is a very leisurely pace. We'll put it that way. We're slow, making everybody mad. So if anybody out there in Fordland knows where some 38s are, like I need to find duals for an 8, 9, 86, or 9600. Because those used the same bolt pattern for the duals for the factory ones. And those will work for 18-4-38s, which I may just have to swipe the tires off the duals of the 1486 because those dual tires are just too good to put them on here. Okay, we gotta watch when we go down. We're gonna cross our end row. Try not to overplant too much, and the marker goes down. Lovely hydraulic sequence valve. I guess we could do this. That's still hoping I can watch the marker, sort of. We've seen me plant sweet corn. I'll put that link here if you want to see more planter. I'm running two different varieties out here right now because I got really low on the variety that I wanted to plant. And, you know, Labor Day, or not Labor Day, Memorial Day weekend really kind of got in the way of getting more. The good news is I'm looking back and forth, and if I'm not following the marker, well, there's more plants or seeds in a crooked row, right? And it's lovely planting with the 66. Plenty of power. The power steering is wonderful. If I was making a turn, I could just use one finger, no problem. After I got everything fitted up correctly, it works great. It's a little ugly because of the hoses, but right now, function over form. The tractor's half yellow anyways. We know what's underneath, it's all good. Just look at it from 50 feet or 50 miles an hour. Or we'll blind you with our brand new lights. How about that? We can't look back for too long. I gotta watch the marker. I'm doing pretty good because it looks like it's staying underneath the center of the planter almost. We're getting a little close. We're cramming too many passes in per acre when we start getting close. Of course, I do like to keep my passes close just to squeeze more passes in, more per acre that way. I don't need 38 inches between planter passes. Those end divider snouts on the combine are maybe only 20. So I'll throw this in here. We're planting wide rows because we use the same planter for all the sweet corn. And let's not try to have too many things to maintain planter-wise. We got plenty of tractors. I'm happy with, you know, one planter for corn. I don't want another one for corn. soil finisher makes it very easy to see the marker mark, just because it leaves it so smooth. Okay, coming to headland again, let's watch. When the fertilizer openers get close to the second row, we lift. I don't have to stop, we could just keep going, but it makes sure we don't overplant the headlands too much. I feel confident in the amount of clutch we have and that we shouldn't burn it out stopping and going. No worse than round baling, right? Now on the way down though, I will drop on the move because I have that timed better since it drops faster. The planter lifts slower than it drops. Gravity's on our side going down. So I'll drop on the move, but I'll lift it stationary most of the time, unless I'm coming into point rows, and then, well, we don't want to overplant, but we want to keep enough seed going so there's not a gap. It's all over the place. But who has ever heard of automatic shutoffs for a four-row planter? And our GPS is doing pretty good. We can see it. We got to have our hand on the wheel, good old-fashioned steering wheel, which somebody's probably noticed there's no cap. That's going to drive me nuts. The new wheel with the new setup is different than the old wheel, so I can't use the old cap, can't use the old wheel. But I think this wheel is about the same as an International, like a 1066, a 1086. So I gotta find a cap. Well, it's getting dark, and I've yammered on for a while. You probably can't hear me over the tractor, and I don't have a fancy enough editor to separate the sound, and the camera, unfortunately, is not as good as the new phones to separate out background noise, but I'm hoping, being on my head, the noise has traveled through my bones and you can hear it. So this has finally been a fun planting video, finally, but as you can see, it's getting dark and we will be putting seed in the ground after dark before the rain tries to ruin our parade, as usual. So for those of you in South and East Texas,